Hey guys, Metalwargod here, and I have a collections update. Some music from whether single artists or bands that I have collections on, and this one features probably my all-time favorite, which is Tommy Bolin, and it goes back into the early years of 1969, and this is probably going to be a two-parter, so bear with me. First up are going to be the CDs, and I'm going to try to go in chronological order. Some of them might be mixed up a little bit, but you know, I did the best I could with them, but anyway, so bear with me. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail, but I'm going to try to show you everything that I do have on CD from Tommy Bolin. And as far as I know, my CDs are complete with just about everything on CD that Tommy Bolin has put out, including the Tommy Bolin Archives, which his brother Johnny Bolin did back, I believe it was in the early 90s when he came up with the Tommy Bolin Archives website. So anyway, and that's where I bought a lot of my CDs from. Some of these are really hard to find. You probably aren't going to find a lot of these today. So anyway, we'll start off early on with Zephyr. Of course, Zephyr was one of the first bands that he formed, and that was back in Colorado. I believe it was about 1967, 68 when he formed Zephyr. This album actually came out, I believe it was 1969 or 1970, and definitely 60s style, excuse me, definitely 60s style, early 70s style hard rock. Some great stuff on here, like Ceylon, Hard Charging Woman, but you can definitely tell the early Tommy Bolin style in his playing. So anyway, this is the first one, Zephyr. Let's see. Up next, then there was the second Zephyr, going back to Colorado. I believe this came out in 1971, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, first release in 1971. And this was actually re-released on CD in, let's see here. No, it doesn't say, but anyway, going back to Colorado, this has See My People Come Together and Show Busy, which are probably the two most standout tracks on this. But the second is Zephyr with Tommy Bolin, going back to Colorado. Let me do something here, man. I gotta get this off. I wanted to keep it on, but... So there we go. Sorry about that. So, yeah. And then up next, he went into some jazz. He did actually have an early jazz band, too, called Energy, which I'll show a little bit later, which kind of chronologically goes into my CD order. But he was in Alphonse Mouzon and in Mind Transplant. And I'm trying to see if this originally came out. That I want to say, this one came out in 93, but ...1975 this came out. So anyway, so we're a little off on the order of CDs, but Killer Jazz, Mind Transplant, and Snowbound are probably my two favorite tracks on this. Good stuff here. And then I think I'm out of order here. If I can remember. Well, I don't have that one, so anyway. On CD. At least I don't think I do. I do not. So anyway, I do have it on vinyl, and I'll show you that in part two. But then he was in a band called Moxie. He appeared on a couple songs. Moxie, of course, a band out of Canada. And, of course, he This came out in the early, I think it was 1973, 72. And he's featured on In Fantasy and Sail On, Sail Away. I'm trying to think of... Earl Johnson really kind of did not want Tommy Bolin to redo a couple tracks on this, but they went ahead and did it anyway. And anyway, this is Boxy's self-titled album. It's a good 70s hard rocking album. It shows his virtuosity and his style and his playing. Definitely a guy can play just about any style on his guitar. Fantastic guitar player. One of my all-time favorites. But anyway, here's Moxie, the debut. And then later on, there was a best of Moxie called Self-Destruction, and this is just some of the best hits from other Moxie albums. Again, this has a couple of songs featuring Tommy Bolin, Sail On, Fantasy, Writer. So, you know, it's just something. If Tommy Bolin's in it, I'm going to get it. I've not seen this on vinyl. This came out, this was released on Unidisc in 1999. So, anyway, good stuff here. Good hard rock album. Up next, he was in a band called James Gang after Joe Walsh left. The James Gang recruited him, and they did this album called Miami. And this is not a real heavy hard rock album. It kind of shows his style a little bit more, whether it's fast paced, slow down, but Cruising Down the Highway, Sleepwalker, and Red Skies, some of my favorite tracks on this. Just the back cover. This one actually came out in originally 1974. So, James Gang, Miami. And then, of course, get James Gang Bang, and this produced James Gang's radio hit, Must Be Love. And this came out originally in 1973. So, and this got. This is probably, I think this is much better than Miami, a little more heavier, a little more guitar focused. Standing in the Rain, The Devil Is Singing Our Song, Alexis, of course, Must Be Love, and just a killer album from James Gang with Tommy Bolin. And then he did some... He did some stuff with Deep Purple. He was in Deep Purple before. I think this was the Mark III Deep Purple. And Deep Purple recruited Tommy Bolin. Of course, when he was in Deep Purple, he wasn't really at his best. He was really, heroin was really rampant with him. He was kind of really stoned out all the time. I don't think his playing was really as focused as it should have been, but he did actually this album here, Come Taste the Band, and this one came out in, this is a re-release on CD in 2007. I think this came out about 1974, if I'm not mistaken, but still a good album, and of course, with Tommy Bolin, you gotta have it. And then there was Deep Purple This Time Around live in Tokyo. And this is actually put out by the Sanctuary Group. This is not part of the Tommy Bolin Archive Collection, but this Come Taste the Band was 75, excuse me. I thought it was 74, but they went around and did a bunch of live shows, and this was one of the live shows, Deep Purple This Time Around, live in Tokyo. Purple set. Good stuff here. Check it out. And then We've got Deep Purple, Days May Come, Days May Go, the California Rehearsal Session, June of 1975. And this has a lot of stuff from Come Taste the Band material, but this was put out by Purple Records. And of course, this features Tommy Bolin, David Coverdale, Glenn Hughes, John Lord, and Ian Pace. And it's a really good Deep Purple album for this era. I really enjoy this. Some good stuff. And then Tommy did, on his own, he did out his own solo stuff. And this was actually where I was first introduced to Tommy Bolin back in 1975. And this was a teaser, great album, great debut. Of course, it has The Grind, Homeward Strut, Dreamer, Savannah Woman, Teaser, People, People, Marching Powder, Wild Dogs, Lotus. Just a great, great album. I think this is really where Tommy Bolin really kind of became more known. But in that aspect, he's still really not widely known by a lot of people. I think people just kind of put him behind a lot of their music. I mean, it's too bad that he isn't with us today. He died in which will be coming up December 4th. This is his anniversary date, and that was 1976 he died. But great album, great release, one of my all-time favorite debut albums, Tommy Bolin, Teaser. And then he followed it up with Private Eyes, which came out in 1976. And this has probably one of my all-time favorite songs he ever done, which was Post Toasty. Again, this is a great album from Tommy Bolin and his solo material stuff. And I mean, great stuff. And we lost him shortly after this. But great album. If you've never heard Tommy Bolin, do yourself a favor and do so. Great stuff. Like again, he's one of my all-time favorite guitar players. And now, this I recently found. I did not know this is out. I'm not sure if it is a bootleg, but I looked at the CD. It is a silver disc. The cover might be homemade, but I found this Tommy Bolin Shake the Devil. And this was live in New York from 1975 and in California in 1976, and some James Gang live in Central Park in 1974. So it's a combination of live stuff as Teaser, You Told Me You Love Me, Shake the Devil, Unreleased Sessions, People, People, The Grind, Wild Dogs, Homeward Strut, Walk Away, Must Be Love. And has, of course, Tommy Bolin, Reggie McBride, Narada Michael Walden, Mark Stein, and Norma Jean Bell. But like I say, I'm not sure. This could be a bootleg, but I did find it. I've never seen another one like this. It was originally priced, and it totals 71 minutes in length. But anyway, pretty sure it's probably a bootleg. So I've only seen one copy. I bought it. I haven't seen another one since. Now we're getting into the archives issues of which his brother Johnny Bolin kind of formed. And these are kind of stuff, music that has been recorded in his early days, whether it's with James Gang, Moxie, Energy, Billy Cobham, or some solo stuff he did. He even did some stuff with the Good Rats. A lot of people did not know that. One of my all-time favorite tracks is Stratus. Great instrumental. It shows his best guitar playing ever on that song. But anyway, this is the first one up. And this is the first Tommy Bolin Archives. And this is live at Ebbets Field, June 3rd and 4th, 1974. And this is a CD that was from Two Nights of Live Material. So this is one of the first in the archive editions from Tommy Bolin. Up next, we got live at Ebbets Field, May 13th, 1976. And again, this is some live material, great stuff. Initially, this is only on the Tommy Bolin Archives website. A lot of this is really hard to find nowadays. I don't know, you might be able to find it, but a lot of it is very, very, very rare now, out of print. But again, some live material from Tommy Bolin. Up next is part of the Tommy Bolin Collector Series. This is Tommy Bolin Band live at Miami and the High Life. At High Life and the final show. I believe this is his final show he ever did before he passed away. Of course, this has Tommy Bolin, Norma Jean Bell, Max Gronthal, Jimmy Haslip, Mark Greeny. Again, another part of the archives. This is Tommy Bolin Archives 3. And a lot of this is live material stuff. And they're still coming out with a lot of Tommy Bolin stuff. And, some of it might be repeated. And there's also some hidden stuff that comes out. But here's number 3 in the archive collection. Up next, just Tommy Bolin, The Bottom Shelf, Volume 1. This is in Tommy Bolin Archive CD 3. I'm going to see what this one was here. This was, they're labeled a little bit differently, but anyway, this is rare live performances, acoustic demos, jams, and ideas in a progress called From the Filthy Plus Reel to Reel Tape. So this is a lot of stuff that never really heard, but this is the Bottom Shelf, Volume 1, with Tommy Bolin. Up next is the Tommy Bolin Band live at Northern Lights Recording Studio, September 22nd, 1976. And this was actually released in 1996. And I'm sure, I think Tommy's brother is on this, if I'm not mistaken. I have to look. Let's see here. Yes, Johnny Bolin is on drums on this particular release. Looks exactly like his brother. Johnny Bolin is right here. Tommy is right there. Anyway, live at Northern Lights Recording Studio, September 22nd, 1976. Up next, this is another Zephyr Live. This was from Art's Bar and Grill on May 2nd, 1973, and Art's Bar and Grill is in Colorado. I believe it's Boulder, Colorado is where they did this live recording. And of course, I forgot to mention, with Zephyr, the vocalist was Candy Givens on this. Fantastic female vocalist from the early, late 60s, early 70s, and great stuff here. It's got a full color 16-page booklet with this. And of course, Tommy Bolin, Candy Givens, David Givens, John Ferris, and Bobby Berge. Bobby Berge was with Tommy Bolin through a lot of his material, but great stuff here. That's part of the archives there. Tommy Bolin Archives is still around. You can go over there. You can still buy some CDs from there. A lot of it is referred to the Friday Music website. So anyway, and now we have Tommy Bolin from the archives. and this is volume one. And this was put out by Rhino Records back initially in 1996. So there are not only was it the Tommy Bolin archives, but different labels were putting out some Tommy Bolin material. And this has demos of a couple songs, Wild Dogs, two versions, Teaser, San Francisco River, Shake the Devil, you know, some of it probably acoustic, some of it's probably live. But anyway, here is Tommy Bolin from the Archives, Volume 1. Up next, Tommy Bolin from the Archives, Volume 2. And this is part of the Tommy Bolin's Archive Collection CD number 7. 20-page booklet. And I'll show you a little bit of this booklet. Very, 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 very awesome booklet. Here's the booklet here. But it kind of has a, tells you a little story about Tommy. But anyway. Tommy Bolin from the Archives, Volume 2. This came out in 1997. Up next, we got Tommy Bolin Archives Collector Series, and you got Tommy Bolin live at the Jet Bar, Sioux City, Iowa, where Tommy is originally from. And this was live in, actually, 11/24/1976. It wasn't much longer after that that he had passed away. Very raw recorded stuff here. And still good stuff, raw stuff, timeless stuff. I mean, it's very timeless material. But Tommy Bolin live at the Jet Bar. And then again, this is another version of this Live at Jet Studio. This is a Friday Music edition. I'm not sure if the CDs are a little bit different on here yet. Let's see here. They are not, they are the same. But one is a Friday edition, as you can see on the back here. Right here, corners. But anyway, Tommy Bolin live at the Jet Bar. And then we got Tommy Bolin, 1976, in his own words. This is more or less interview. This is an interview CD of stuff from September, November of 1976, and you know it. This is also part of the Archive CD 8, 9. And again, you know, just you can really tell he's really stoned out on heroin on a lot of this stuff. But anyway, Tommy Bolin in his own words. Up next, this was some of the early stuff Tommy was in. He was in a band called Energy. The radio broadcast, and this is from 1972. Energy was a jazz band, and he loved the jazz, he loved the blues, he loved hard rock. Very talented guitar wise. He could play just about any style of music, and anyway. Tommy Bolin, the Energy radio broadcast. This originally came out in 1998 on the Tommy Bolin Archives. And then up next is Tommy Bolin, the 1997 tribute featuring Glenn Hughes, Johnny Bolin, and Friends. And of course, the Friends were Terry Brooks, Ralph Patlin, Robert Ware, Johnny Bolin, Glenn Hughes. this was done at Denver's Bluebird Theater. Every year they have a Tommy Bolin Fest down in Sioux City, Iowa, too. And I believe that's coming up in December, so look forward. I've never been there. I've always wanted to go. But anyway, some more Tommy Bolin with the 1997 tribute. And then here is Tommy Bolin and Energy. This is a part of the archive collection, CD 13. The year is 1972. Tommy Bolin and Energy got a record, or they couldn't get a record deal, and doing some fabulous music, amazing band. They can't get a deal to see who stands the test of time. Definitely a good CD if you ever see it. I don't think you'll ever see them on vinyl. These are mostly on CD. So anyway, Tommy Bolin and Energy. Excuse me. And then we got Tommy Bolin, Come Taste the Band. This is archive CD 15. And this has a lot of live material. Some demo stuff, but this originally came out in 1999. So you can see each year was a kind of progression where the archives put out a lot of different stuff. But here is Tommy Bolin, Come Taste the Man. And then we got Tommy Bolin, Naked 2. This is Tommy Bolin Archive CD 23. It kind of jumped around a little bit, but 18 tracks. This is called from the first generation of reel-to-reel tapes that Tommy Bolin did at Glen Holly Studios. And some of these are on his solo. Some of them are on, most of these are from the solo stuff, but here is, this originally came out, 2002. Here is Tommy Bolin, Naked 2. And then we have Tommy Bolin Snapshot, and this is Purple Pyramid label put this one out. And all these are unreleased material: Savannah Woman, Standing in the Rain, a lot of Miami James Gang stuff, Cucumber Jam. He did some stuff with Fleetwood Mac as well, and that was one of them songs. But Homeward Strut from solo material. And here is Tommy Bolin in Snapshot. And up next is Tommy Bolin and Whips and Roses. This came out in 2006 on the Steamhammer label, division of SPB. And I'm surprised that Steamhammer actually put this out. These are teaser sessions that were unreleased, and they were put on this album. Running time is almost 80 minutes on this, so good stuff here. Like I say, 2002. Up next, we got Tommy Bolin, Whips and Roses 2. And this also was put out by SPV. And this come out in 2006. And this has The Grind, Crazy Fandango, People, Spacey Noodles, Lotus, Bolin's Boogie, a lot of different stuff that was not on previous CDs that I know of. But good stuff here. Tommy Bolin, Whips and Roses 2. And then we have a 2-CD set of Tommy Bolin and Friends with Great Gypsy Soul. And a trying to see, it has Joe Bonamassa on there, Glenn Hughes, Sonny Landreth, Big Sugar, and Gordy Johnson, Brad Whitford, Miles Kennedy, and on disc one. So this is kind of a friend CD that was kind of a dedication to Tommy Bolin. And it has a bonus disc of some Tommy Bolin material, Marching Bag. Two versions of that, Marching Bag, three versions. Actually, there's five versions of Marching Bag on this. Four versions, excuse me. And then it has Flying Fingers. So anyway, good stuff here. And it also has, I believe this is Warren Haynes. Warren Haynes in the bottom down here. So a lot of different artists on this. And Glenn Hughes, absolutely loved Tommy Bolin. He was one of the reasons Tommy Bolin got into Deep Purple, is because of Glenn Hughes. Major influence on Tommy Bolin. And you'll hear Glenn Hughes talk about Tommy Bolin all the time. But anyway, here is Three Gypsy Souls. And then we have Tommy Bolin captured live. And a lot of these are guest musicians, of course, Bobby Berge, Jeff Beck, Todd Rundgren, Richie Zito, Joey Carbone. Just a lot of killer artists that contributed on this. And very, very raw. Very raw sounding. I mean, definitely came from recordings that were not professional studios. They were recorded raw sounding from fans or his brother that did a lot of this stuff. But anyway, here's Tommy Bolin, captured raw. Then we're getting down there to a few. And then we got Tommy Bolin and the Glenn Holly Jams, Volume 1, After Hours. And disc one, these are mostly jam songs on here. And this is part of the archive CD 24 and 25. I kind of missed this one, but this one actually came out in, 2002. And, again, some great stuff. And I got a few more left. Then we got Tommy Bolin, The Ultimate Redone. Three-disc set. And if you're familiar with The Ultimate, it was a box set that came out in the 90s. And good stuff. And here is a collection here, but three-disc set. Put out by Friday Music, and definitely worth picking up if you ever come across it. And then we have Tommy Bolin, the Definitive Teaser Collector's Edition, five CDs, and what has been said on the back is Tommy Bolin was the heir apparent to Jimi Hendrix's rock guitar throne, with the original release of Teaser following his work with James Gang, Deep Purple, Billy Cobham. And this is five disc set. Again, it has the Teaser three disc set, and it has Great Gypsy Soul, two discs, so good stuff here. I love Tommy Bolin, always have, always will, and this is part of the CD collection. And I have actually two left. I have Tommy Bolin Worldwing. This is a limited edition. I have number 220, put out by Cleopatra Records. And this has, of course, Tommy Bolin patch, a button, guitar pick. It's a postcards. In addition, just a couple more here. And then it has the CD set, which is a 2-disc set. Which is awesome. And it is a box set. I'm not sure if you can actually find these anymore. They might still be around, but very, very limited into getting these. But here's Tommy Bolin Whirlwind. 220 marked down here. And last is I do have the original box set of Tommy Bolin, The Ultimate, 2-compact disc retrospective featuring rare text and photographs. And the box is in pretty good shape. I remember years ago I was going to throw this away, and I'm glad I never did, you know. But you can still find these. It's also available in vinyl, but is very, very expensive. Here's the book that comes with it. And it has a lot of cool stuff in there, pictures, the story, and this particular picture on back, is you can really tell he's really stoned out here, but anyway, this is the archive set, or the ultimate set, and an original, and I'm so glad that I do have this, because I don't know what I would have done if I had thrown this away, and I'm glad I kept it. So anyway, that is my Tommy Bolin collection CDs part one. I have the vinyls coming up in part two, so stick around and you will get to listening to and watching part two from Tommy Bolin Archives collection. See you in a little bit.